Today I'm really excited to introduce you to Michelle McNeil. She's been on our team since about July 2023, and she's a very interesting, dynamic person, and I'm just excited for you to learn a little bit more about her. So Michelle, thanks so much for coming on today. So tell me, what did you do prior to, you know, dipping your foot, or actually let's say jumping right into the, you know, the river that is real estate?
I do feel like I jumped in. But before real estate, I did, debt collection. So student loans, mostly. So helping out people who had unfortunately found themselves in a defaulted student loan situation and helping them find a way out. So it's not an ideal situation, but helping people was the best part of that job.
Yeah, for sure. So when you're not crushing it in real estate, what are you doing for fun?
I mean, I like to be outside. I like to walk anywhere that's nature related. So the beach or anything woodsy, all of the paths. New Hampshire is gorgeous. And especially this time of year. I mean, it's early October. The leaves are just starting to change and there's so much to see. I find it's very stress reducing just to be out in nature.
What other things? I know you organize a pretty cool game community.
I do. It's a Midwestern thing. I'm from Detroit originally, and you'll find a lot of us kind of from that Rust Belt area play a card game called Euchre, which is just a real quick partner game where the only weird thing is the jack of the same color as Trump but the opposite suit gets to be Trump just for that one hand. But it's a quick game and it lets you spend time kind of catching up with friends and keeping your hands busy. So. I did organize a group here in Concord of kind of people who are from the Midwest who know how to play. So we have a good time.
That's awesome. And I don't know if you're going to talk about this, but you also organized something else that's really cool. That is more of musical. Would you be willing to talk about that?
My little one's drum circle. I've always had a soft spot for the kids, you know, for little ones. And they're at an age where they can learn anything that they're interested in and they're like little sponges. So I've learned how to drum African Caribbean drumming, so all hand drums, and teaching those skills to kids. Everyone has a sense of rhythm, everyone. You have a heartbeat, you have a sense of rhythm. But kids don't have that I'm shy or I'm embarrassed yet, and they just let it out. So it's fun to watch, and I think it's an honor to get to be involved in it. And have parents bring their kids, and they just have a good time for 30, 40 minutes, and then, you know, they're off to a good night's sleep after that.
Awesome. Is there anything else that I know those are like kind of, I was poking you for those two things, but is there anything else that you want to talk about really quick before we sign off?
I mean, my fun passion really just is crochet. I love the feel of the yarn. I like making gifts for people. And then you also get to work with artists. So I like those hand-dyed natural, you know, fibers. So there's a lot of artistry that goes into making those colors and being able to put them together into something new. It fits in with everything else, right? Like I like puzzles and creating things. So crochet fits kind of all those boxes. And you can't always be outside. Sometimes the weather's not ideal. So crochet.
That's amazing. Well, thank you for opening up yourself to me and to everybody that's watching this. I know that if you're out there and you have any of these shared interests, reach out to Michelle and she's always here for you if you want to make a move. Thanks for watching.